Bible words and verses, what the Bible says. Question: Was Mary a virgin for the rest of her life after she delivered Jesus? Answer: No, Mary was not a virgin for the rest of her life after she delivered Jesus. Joseph knew not Mary till after Jesus was born. Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which, being interpreted, is God with us. Then Joseph, being raised from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took unto him his wife, and knew her not till she had brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus. Jesus had brothers and sisters. Is not this the carpenter, the son of Mary, the brother of James and Joseph, and of Judah and Simon? And are not his sisters here with us? And they were offended at him. Jesus was the firstborn of Mary's children. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Question: What is the virgin birth? Answer: The virgin birth is the biblical truth that Jesus was conceived inside Mary's womb by the power of the Holy Ghost, and Mary, being a virgin, gave birth to Jesus. Question: Is the virgin birth the same as the Immaculate Conception? Answer: No, the virgin birth is not the same as the Immaculate Conception. Question: What then is the Immaculate Conception? Answer: The Immaculate Conception is a doctrine of traditions which states that Mary, when Mary herself was conceived in the womb of her mother, Mary did not inherit original sin from her parents. Question: Is the Immaculate Conception in the Bible? Answer: No, the Immaculate Conception is not in the Bible. The virgin birth, however, is in the Bible. Jesus Christ was born of a virgin. Mary was a virgin when Christ was born. The following are attributes given to Mary by traditions, but they are not in the Bible. This Mary of traditions is a different Mary, not the Mary of the Bible. The Mary of the Bible is a virtuous woman and an example to all true Christians. If the Mary of traditions is a different Mary, not the Mary of the Bible, who then is the Mary of traditions? The children gather wood, and the fathers kindle the fire, and the women knead their dough, to make cakes to the Queen of Heaven, and to pour out drink offerings unto other gods, that they may provoke me to anger. But we will certainly do whatsoever thing goeth forth out of our own mouth, to burn incense unto the Queen of Heaven, and to pour out drink offerings unto her, as we have done, we and our fathers, our kings, and our princes, in the city of Judah, and in the streets of Jerusalem. For then had we plenty of victuals, and were well, and saw no evil. Here are six attributes given to Mary, which are not in the Bible. 1. Mary is sinless and a perpetual virgin. 2. Mary has a place in grace and salvation. 3. Mary's assumption unto heaven or ascension. 4. Mary is a mediatrix or mediator. 5. Mary is an advocate and a helper. And 6. Mary is the All-Holy One. If we carefully read those attributes, they are attributes of the three that bear record in heaven. The first four are attributes of Jesus Christ. Number 5 is the Holy Ghost or Comforter, and number 6 is God the Father. The biblical Mary was a virtuous woman, but she was a sinner. Mary inherited original sin, and Mary needs a Savior. Mary's parents also inherited original sin. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ shall all be made alive. Question: Is Mary a sinner who needs a Savior? Answer: Yes, Mary is a sinner who needs a Savior. And my spirit hath rejoiced in God my Savior. Question: Is Mary a perpetual virgin? Answer: No, Mary is not a perpetual virgin, because after Jesus was born, Joseph knew her, and Jesus was Mary's firstborn of at least 4 brothers and 2 sisters. Question: Does Mary have a place in grace? Answer: No, Mary does not have a place in grace. Mary is an elect child of God, thereby receiving the grace of God, but Mary herself is not the giver of grace. For the law was given by Moses, but grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. Question: Does Mary have a place in salvation? Answer: No, Mary does not have a place in salvation. Mary receives salvation, but Mary is not the giver of salvation. For God hath not appointed us to wrath, but to obtain salvation by our Lord Jesus Christ. Question: Was there an assumption of Mary into heaven? In other words, was Mary ascended into heaven? Answer: No. There was no assumption or ascension of Mary into heaven. And no man hath ascended up to heaven but he that came down from heaven, even the Son of Man which is in heaven. No man hath seen God at any time. The only begotten Son, which is in the bosom of the Father, he hath declared him. But now is Christ risen from the dead and become the first fruits of them that slept. But every man in his own order, Christ the first fruits, afterward they that are Christ's at his coming. Question: Is Mary a mediatrix or a mediator? Answer: No, Mary is not a mediatrix or a mediator. For there is one God and one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus. Jesus saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Question: Is Mary an advocate? Answer: No, Mary is not an advocate. My little children, these things write I unto you, that ye sin not. And if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. Question: Is Mary a helper? Answer: No, Mary is not a helper. Hear, O Lord, and have mercy upon me. Lord, be thou my helper. Behold, God is mine helper. The Lord is with them that uphold my soul. So that we may boldly say, The Lord is my helper, and I will not fear what man shall do unto me. The Holy Ghost is our Comforter. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things, and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. But when the Comforter is come, whom I will send unto you from the Father, even the Spirit of truth, which proceedeth from the Father, he shall testify of me. Question: Is Mary the All-Holy One? Answer: No, Mary is not the All-Holy One. And thou shalt hang up the veil under the tashes, that thou mayest bring in thither within the veil the ark of the testimony, and the veil shall divide unto you between the holy place and the most holy. God is the most holy, and God will not give his glory to another. I am the Lord, that is my name, and my glory will I not give to another, neither my praise to graven images. Question: Is Mary deity? Answer: No, Mary is not deity, nor did the Mary of the Bible want anyone to elevate her to deity, or to be worshipped for that matter, as she did proclaim that God is her Savior. The deity is the three that bear record in heaven. For there are three that bear record in heaven: the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost, and these three are one. Question: What is the cruel consequence of the doctrine of the Immaculate Conception? Answer: The doctrine of the Immaculate Conception, by declaring that Mary herself was born without inheriting original sin, implies that Mary did not inherit the sin flesh of Adam, and this has severe consequences in light of the following verse: Wherefore, as by one man sin entered into the world, and death by sin, and so death passed upon all men, for that all have sinned. God sent his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh. Christ is the only person born in this earth who did not inherit the sinful flesh of Adam. For what the law could not do, in that it was weak through the flesh, God, sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh, and for sin, condemned sin in the flesh. Hereby know ye the Spirit of God: every spirit that confesseth that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is of God, and every spirit that confesseth not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is not of God, and this is that spirit of Antichrist whereof ye have heard that it should come, and even now already is it in the world. For many deceivers are entered into the world, who confess not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh. This is a deceiver and an antichrist. Question: Is Mary in heaven? Answer: No, Mary is not in heaven. But now is Christ risen from the dead, and become the first fruits of them that slept. but every man in his own order, Christ the first fruits, afterward they that are Christ's at his coming. If Mary is not in heaven, where is she? The dead sleep. These things said he, and after that he saith unto them, Our friend Lazarus sleepeth, but I go that I may awake him out of sleep. Then said his disciples, Lord, if he sleep, he shall do well. Howbeit, Jesus spake of his death, but they thought that he had spoken of taking of rest in sleep. Then said Jesus unto them plainly, Lazarus is dead. Should we pray to the dead and for the dead? No, we should not pray to the dead or for the dead, as there is no biblical basis for it. Should we pray to Mary or for Mary or any saint? No, because the Mary of the Bible died, and Mary or any saint is not in heaven, and Mary is not deity. The Mary of the Bible died, as does everyone else, with the exception of those still alive at the second coming. And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground, and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. Then shall the dust return to the earth as it was, and the spirit shall return unto God who gave it. His breath goeth forth, he returneth to his earth. In that very day his thoughts perish. Mary is not in heaven. And no man hath ascended up to heaven, but he that came down from heaven, even the Son of Man, which is in heaven. No man hath seen God at any time, the only begotten Son, which is in the bosom of the Father, he hath declared him. Men and brethren, let me freely speak unto you of the patriarch David, that he is both dead and buried, and his sepulchre is with us unto this day. For David is not ascended into the heavens, but he saith himself, The Lord said unto my Lord, Sit thou on my right hand. No man can come to me, except the Father which hath sent me draw him, and I will raise him up at the last day. But every man in his own order, Christ the first fruits, afterward they that are Christ's at his coming. Mary is not in heaven, and respectfully, neither are Enoch and Elijah. More on Enoch and Elijah shortly. Mary is not deity. For there are three that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost, and these three are one. I am the Lord, that is my name, and my glory will I not give to another, neither my praise to graven images. Question: Is there a verse in the Bible that may be misinterpreted and that may lead people to believe that Mary and our deceased relatives are in heaven? Answer: Perhaps it's Luke 23, verse 43. And Jesus said unto him, Verily I say unto thee, today shalt thou be with me in paradise. Many times when we read the Bible, we read it from man's point of view. But is it possible that Jesus answered the second thief's question from God's point of view? Christ is God. God's name is I Am. God is eternal. God exists outside of time. To God, every day is today. The second thief on the cross, being an elect child of God, would die that day. And the next time he opens his eyes, he will be with the Lord today from God's perspective. Question: If we are not to pray to or for Mary, then whom are we to pray to? Answer: We are to pray to God our Father, who is in heaven. We are to pray for others as well. It's not my Father, but our Father. We are to glorify God and to give Him His due respect. After this manner, therefore, pray ye. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. For if ye forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if ye forgive not men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. Question: Beyond the Lord's Prayer, the Our Father, does the Bible prescribe any other prayer formula? Answer: No, there is no other prayer formula. We are to pray the Lord's Prayer, and we are not to use vain repetitions. Vain repetitions is saying the same prayer over and over again. Here is how the Lord Jesus Christ instructs us to pray. And when thou prayest, thou shalt not be as the hypocrites are, for they love to pray standing in the synagogues and in the corners of the streets, that they may be seen of men. Verily I say unto you, they have their reward. But thou, when thou prayest, enter into thy closet, and when thou hast shut thy door, pray to thy Father, which is in secret, and thy Father which seeth in secret shall reward thee openly. But when ye pray, use not vain repetitions, as the heathen do, for they think that they shall be heard for their much speaking. Be not ye, therefore, like unto them, for your Father knoweth what things ye have need of before ye ask him.